Hi everyone. So in this video we will see that we have a Node.js installed or not. Okay, so what you can do is after installing this node version manager, what you need to do is you just need to check if you have this running or not, right? I can see all these commands also. This is the help text which is coming after I did NVM. So I can also check, do I have node version installed? Yes. If you installed a node version manager, you can just write this command, nvm install node. So it will install the latest version of node on your system, and after that you just need to do node minus v. It will give you the version which is already on your system. You can verify it like this. Here I'm currently inside a node console, so that means Node.js is installed in my system. That's what you need for the environment setup. Now, extending this environment setup video to a little bit further, what else you need? So you have npm and you have Node.js. I mean, npm is coming with the Node.js. How you can verify it is you can just simply hit this npm init command, which will actually ask you some few things, and it will be able to create a package.json for you. So if I do this, when I do npm init, it will ask me a few things. What is my project name, blah blah blah, and it will create a package.json in the test. You can see we'll talk about this npm thing in separate video, but now I can verify that okay, everything is working. I have npm, I have a node.js, and when I need, I can just do npm install minus minus save react and react DOM. These two packages I need. So these are actually JavaScript packages. I wanted to write a React application, so I need these two packages available locally in my workspace so that I can consume these packages and write React components. You can see in the test, we can see both the packages are there. React is helping us to create the component. React DOM will help us to visualize those components on somewhere on your browser. Okay. I think this should be fine for now, like the basic installation and setup we have done for the environment. Now, one important thing which I wanted to talk about is this particular Git book, which I have published earlier, but this will help you to get started with React. Okay, it is talking about what is React. React is a declarative. React makes it painless to create an interactive UI, right? React is a component based. Everything you will write in React will be a component. You are writing header, footer, body, sidebar, navbar, table, grid. Everything will be a component based, because that will be a single independent piece of code which will maintain its state, which will maintain props. Everything will be inside it. Okay. Now learn once, write anywhere. You create a component, you push it to npm, you make it component as a reusable. You don't need to rewrite it. Once you create a data grid, data table, or some kind of a nice component, like React Format is there, React Grid is there, React Table. These are actually NPM modules I'm talking about. So somebody has already created these React component and published there on the NPM repository. Now we are using them. Okay. So learn once, write anywhere. You have to write it, learn once and write anywhere and reuse it everywhere. Okay. Now next thing is the roadmap. Roadmap is just talking about what we are going to cover and how things will go. Okay. React.js is simply one of the leading JavaScript library, and there are other frameworks like React, which is Angular, Vue, Backbone, Ember. I will not do that. So there is only a relevant comparison between three: Angular, Vue and React, because these three are coming from the major vendors: Facebook, Google, and I don't know, third one. Yeah. So React.js, what you need is, as a prerequisite, you just need to have basic knowledge of HTML, CSS and JavaScript. That should be enough. And in this training outline, we'll be talking about all these things. So there is a big list which you can go through. I will share this particular link. I mean, I will be covering more than this. So here, currently we are at this introduction of React.js. We are talking about different framework. We have done the basic installation. Then we will do the quick comparison between all these frameworks, how they are different, how React is different, and why you should learn React and add this in your skills. Okay. And you can follow this sections because I will be covering most of the things from here. I mean, you can correlate things if you're not able to understand. So this is a Git book I already published. I will be sharing the link. Okay. Coming to our Hello World React component now. So I will be just removing this test thing that was just for demo. Okay. So what is actually a React component? React component is nothing but it is just a piece of UI code we will be writing. And React component is built of two things you need to understand. First of all, it is all JavaScript. It is all vanilla JavaScript you will be writing either in the ES5 or ES6. So it is all JavaScript, okay? Second thing is we will be mixing JavaScript with something else that is called JSX. So till today, whenever I'm building UI, what I was doing, I was writing a JavaScript differently, separately, and HTML separately, right? But from now with React, we will be mixing up both the things, JavaScript and this HTML or JSX. This is called JSX because this look like HTML or XML like syntax. Okay. Then with the help of both the things, we are building a component. And now this component can be anything. This can be a piece of UI which is representing a complex data grid or a simple hello world message. Anything it can be, okay? This is a UI component. Now, once the component is ready, what minimum thing you need to write a hello world component? Just a class and render function, okay? In initial videos, we will talk only about a class-based component. Don't get confused that earlier there was a function. Okay, there are many ways to write a component. Either you write a function or either you write a class. With the ES6 in JavaScript, now we are able to write classes, so you can take the advantage of writing classes. Earlier we were writing functions, but in the recent version of React, now they have evolved and provided a nicer way or cleaner way of writing component without even using classes. Those are called functional component, okay? We'll come to that point, but here I created a hello component. Okay, and now we are writing ES6, so we are using the import, export, classes, all these things. So this hello component minimal is having render function. Your component is a UI component. That means it should represent something on the UI. Then only it will become a component, right? Here it can be anything. In the return, you will be literally writing the HTML, XML syntax. So okay, it can be anything like div. Inside that div, you are writing hello world, and then my first component, something like this. So what this component is giving you as outcome, it is giving you some message, hello world and my first component. And where it is giving you, how you will be able to see this on the UI, because we are not writing index.html and patching it there. We are created a component, and now this line react-dom.render will decide that where this component is going to be displayed. Right? Here we are creating an instance of a component. And we are rendering this component on some ID. So you already know how to access the DOM, document.get element by ID, document.query selector, get element by tag name, document.get element by class name. All these other specifiers are there on document, which will help you to access, like these are the methods. Get element by ID, class name, tag name. Right, to access a particular DOM. So what this line is saying, okay, I have the UI component with me, which will show something to the user. How do I mount it? So this thing will mount it on the ID app in the index.html, and I will be having index.html. I will be putting the ID as app. So this place, it will be patching the UI here. Okay, that's enough for this video without making it long. So in the next sections, we will just talk about this JSX more. And how React is actually compiling or giving us an opportunity to write HTML and JavaScript together. Because browser can't read it, browser can't understand if you try to write something like this and how it is happening. Okay, thanks everyone.